Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the SMAs. Happened in March 2015 on the 7th day. Thanks to the good folks at Golf Course Hotel. So let's go over last year's trending media details. Bebe lost to school with Ugandan radio DJs, leading to a heated exchange between him and BK. Suspiciously happening around the time of the release date of a SMAs song and video Love You Every Day. Way before Gravity Omutujju's broken English, they were still dissing Eddie Kenzo spoken Misfits. When the Sitya Loss dance video with them six kids started doing the opposite of what they all predicted. That song broke the internet, and some might have doubted, but it was all over soon as Diddy tweeted about it. And whether 2014's crazes were seen as healthy or not, it was definitely the year of the selfie. Everyone was taking one, it was all a rave. Even President Museveni got in on the craze. Got a Twitter account and he took his first selfie. Had over 30k followers in his first 12 tweets. But no East African had it going on more than Kenya's Miss Lupita Amida Nyong'o. Her rise to fame off of 12 years a slave had a quarter from everybody from Jay-Z to Lecrae. Her rise to fame was monstrous. She was even part of Ellen's sister be making group selfie at the Oscars. As some careers arrived, sadly others were leaving coffins. R.I.P. Robin Williams and Philip Seymour Hoffman. The legacies will always have the respect of their peers, unlike others using news to resurrect their careers. Luzinda's leaks had the locals burning with desire. Sadly, the response to those Azaris was slightly dry. So while Chameleon's million show aimed for platinum, Zari took a leaf and that solicited a diamond. As Kenzo reigned on the continental charts with his music, he also rained blows on the journalists that accused him. And last year's UG's politics drama was prominent. Pigs didn't fly, but they sure snuck in the parliament. And Mama's popularity was rising so much higher than the president that hired him that he just had to fire him. Took it like a boss to keep a media silence. Getting his wife through all the fighting back and criticizing all that pre-election tension, peeps just needed to chill. And the word of the day just seemed to be bills, bills, bills. Cause while I was grinding to pay my electrical bill, they passed and threw out the anti-homosexual bill. Dudes would look for chicks in minis and then dress them for real, all because of them passing the anti-pornography bill. Chicks had to take to the streets and just they bras and protest. Talk about getting something important off of your chest. Cats hashtagging on Twitter to save the miniskirt, while Ebola had West Africa on high risk alert. Speaking of high risk alert up in the West, Boko Haram was as low down dirty as it gets. Kidnapping over 200 girls in Nigeria, from out of its Tibok village, northeast area. Facebook knows what's up and that's literal now. For that acquisition, they put 22 mil on the ground. Still yet to see a like icon pop up in my chat box, but like net reaction to Kim Kardashian's back shots, that wouldn't surprise me. Like soccer driving girls nuts, having to forego their men's attention during World Cup. It happened in Brazil as Argentina lost to Germany. And speaking of loss, I can say this with all certainty. Jolie must have lost her brain. Regardless of whether you call her the evil nanny or the monster maid, I know I'm saved by the blood of the sun. But if that was me and my daughter, only God knows what I would have done. And another related news, Pistorius got sentenced. Only three words, Pistorius got sentenced. Had those three words to make up that sentence is still longer than the term of Pistorius' whole sentence. In an effort to touch on something nice for a balance, millions were raised in last year's ice bucket challenge, where peeps would pour ice water buckets over their heads or donate dough to promote awareness of ALS. That campaign went viral. The stats currently show that it brought in at least a million in every currency. And this ain't really news in my view. Once again, Ugandans and Kenyans beefed on Twitter like they usually do. Since Kenyatta's stolen car just sort of passed our borders, apparently the stats for jackars winding up here's enormous. And Kasima became part of Africa Comedy's Who's Who. And Katoto started exploding in fame on YouTube. Cindy Samuel lost her kids' custody to Mario's. Juliana lost Karen, rest in peace. What dignity, handled that situation like a queen. And those were the media trenders of 2014. So everybody please, hope you enjoy in your seats. Thanks for telling Africa and Blue Flamingo in his peace. With that little decree, please welcome with me the Social Media Awards for 2015.
Yes, everything around me.